dear students, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we shall be discussing a practical of the subject switchgear and protection. The aim of the practical is to identify the various switchgear components in the laboratory. So let's get started. The first switchgear device that we will discuss today is a fuse. Fuse is one of the most basic type of protective device which is used in the laboratories as well as at our homes. Fuses are of different types and they have different ratings depending upon their types. Basically, a fuse is a device which is used for overcurrent and short circuit protection in case of a fault. So here you can see that there are different types of fuses. First, you can see that there are glass cartridge fuse. So these are the glass cartridge type fuses of different ratings. Like you can see 4 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, 15 ampere and 20 ampere. So the cartridge or the outer casing of this type of fuse is made up of glass. That is why these type of fuses are known as the glass cartridge type fuse. Then the next we have are the porcelain cartridge fuses. So their outer casing is made up of porcelain. That is why they are called as porcelain cartridge fuse. And because this has a shape like a cartridge, that is why it is known as a cartridge fuse. So these are the different ratings: 2 ampere, 4 ampere, 6 ampere and 10 ampere. The next type is the KitKat type of fuse, which is mostly used everywhere. So this is a 16 ampere KitKat fuse. It has a fuse base and this element over here is known as the fuse carrier. So the fuse wire, which is used for protection purpose, is placed inside this fuse carrier and then this fuse carrier is inserted inside the fuse base. Then the next are the HRC fuses, which are also known as the high rupturing capacity fuses. So these are the different types of HRC fuse. HRC fuses are different when you compare them with the normal type of fuses because the current carrying capacity of the HRC fuse is much higher than that of the normal fuses. So that is why HRC fuses are used in the power system for protection purpose. HRC fuses basically they consist of heat resisting ceramic body which have these metallic end caps. So this entire body is heat resistant and if you try to read out the current rating 63 ampere, 16 ampere. So these are the fuses which have higher rating when you compare them with the normal fuses. So these are the different types of fuses along with their rating. The next protective device that we are discussing is known as the MCB, which stands for the miniature circuit breaker. So basically fuses have a few disadvantages that the fusing element needs to be replaced after every operation because when the fault occurs, for example a short circuit occurs, the fuse element may melt. So we have to replace it. So to avoid that manual effort of replacing the fuse element and to save time, we make use of the automatic fuses which are known as the circuit breakers. And these are the basic type of circuit breaker, which are the miniature circuit breaker, which stands for MCB. So basically, miniature circuit breaker can break a circuit under the condition of short circuit and overload. So here we have three different types of MCB. This is the single pole MCB, this is the two pole MCB and this is the three pole MCB that we have taken as an example over here. So we can see that the MCBs have some namings or ratings written on them. So here this B16 over here stands for the model of this particular MCB. Then here we can see that the on off position is indicated on this MCB. This is the operating or you can say rated voltage, 240 or 415 volt depending on our application. And this current rating that is shown over here, 6000 ampere, this is the braking capacity of this MCB. That means braking capacity stands for how much current this particular MCB can withstand without getting damaged. So that is the braking capacity. So that this is the device, this is the next protective device that we have discussed, that is the miniature circuit breaker. The next protective device that we have is known as the ELCB, that is the earth leakage circuit breaker. So ELCB basically is a safety device that is used in the electrical installation with high impedance to prevent shock. So this particular device can detect small stray voltages on the metal enclosure of the electrical equipment, and it interrupts the circuit if a dangerous voltage is detected. So in case there is any leakage current flowing through the metal enclosure of any appliance, and if a human being touches it, the current may flow from the body of the human being and we may experience a shock. So to protect the human beings from such shock, these ELCBs are installed everywhere. You can observe these ELCBs even at your home or in your college. So these ELCBs basically are safety devices. These are used to protect the human beings or the animals, and as well as to protect the equipment in the event that a leakage current has started to flow from the metallic enclosure of the appliance. So this basically is a ELCB. So this is a 4-pole ELCB with an MCB. So it is incorporated with an MCB. So the next protective device are the current transformers. So these are nothing but the instrument transformer. We have already discussed the instrument transformers in the electrical measurement. So basically the function of the current transformer or CT is to step down the current. So in case of power system, CTs are used to step down the fault current and then give that reduced current to the protective devices, because whenever a short circuit or any type of fault occurs in the power system, the current rating of that fault is very high, and that large amount of current cannot be given to the protective devices, or else the size of the protective devices will become very large. So what we do is we step down that current, we reduce that current with the help of the current transformer, and then we give that current to the protective devices for purpose of protection. Similarly, we also have the potential transformer, that is PT, and the function of PT is to step down the voltage. So here we have this current transformer. All the ratings and standards are mentioned over here. The most important thing is the ratio of this CT, which is 100:5. That means this CT will step down 100 ampere to 5 ampere. So this particular current transformer can be used in a power system so as to reduce the value of the fault current. The next protective device that we have over here is a relay. So for an example, we have this electromechanical overcurrent relay. Basically, the function of a relay is to sense the occurrence of a fault and give the tripping command to the circuit breaker. So this relay will sense overcurrent type of fault, because you can see that overcurrent is mentioned over here. And once the overcurrent has occurred, this type of relay will give a tripping command to the circuit breaker, and the circuit breaker will trip and isolate the faulty section from the healthy part of the power system. I hope you shall now be able to identify the different switchgear components at your home as well as the laboratory. Thank you for watching the video.